chapter 2. We'll move on to chapter 3, which is modeling in time domain. In this time domain modeling, what we are going to talk about is state space representation. Okay. Have you guys learned about state space representation in your stability and control class? Don't remember?
Yeah.
We're going to talk about alright, we'll introduce a few terminologies before we start talking about what is state representation. And you should be aware of these by now. The first one is linear combination. Linear combination. From n variables. No cell phones, John?
Yes.
It's fairly simple. Here x, n, x, n minus 1, all the x's are what? Variable. Okay. And if we can represent s as a, these k n, k n minus 1 are all constants. Okay. So that is a, this is a linear combination essentially. Okay. Second one is linear independent. And we are talking about linear combination, linear independence in the context of variables. So linear independence is for example, let's say you're talking about by definition, it is very simple. If you know these two, okay, and you can express x3 as a combination of these two, this is not new information. Right?
You are
done. Huh? Right, the value of x3 is something not new. It is just a linear combination of this. So, for example, here. You know two sides of a triangle. The first side is just a linear combination, or you would know that information as well. It is not something new. Okay? So that is linear independence, linear dependence. And again, even if x1 can be expressed as some if x1 is expressed as some value of x2. Or sometimes x2. X1 is not a linearly independent variable. System variable.
approximation of invisible. And
so if think about what a system variable is. If you're talking about a spring mass damper system, what could be the system variable? That is the input always. It's not a something that responds to an input or initial condition. What responds? Spring. So what happens to the spring?
Displacement.
So displacement is a variable, system variable, right? It responds to an input. State variable is essentially the smallest head of linearly independent system. So what this means is, if you know a system variable and you know the forcing function, what is the function, what is the input at time t equal to 0, the smallest set of linearly independent variables, such variables, known at all other times would be state variables. You'll get a better idea when we actually do the do an example. And state vector is quite simply the column matrix of the state variable. And state space. Finally, what we have is Recently you said that simultaneous equation these are the definitions you should be aware of when you're talking about state-space model. Okay? So we'll take a look at an example and we'll evaluate each of these. Okay? Yeah, we're done with definitions. We just compare what the definitions mean. general state space representation. Everything is capitalized here, and you have to remember, you have to keep in mind that each of these is terms is a matrix. Again, it's not a, for example, x naught, x is the state vector. A is the system matrix. What I'll do is, we won't go into exclusively modeling state space. What we'll do is, we'll take a look at how to convert a transfer function into a state space model. Is that okay? We'll start with a simple two-mass system.
Sorry.
this is your simple two-mass system, okay, M1, M2. Can you quickly tell me what are the system variables here?
So, first variable is C, just C, right?
No, C is not a variable.
Alright.
C is a constant.
Then you should just skip straight to X1 and X2.
Right. X1 and X2 are? See, these are always constants. Don't keep forgetting. M1, is it a variable or a constant? Everything is a constant. Only you have to look at variable as something like this. X1 of t. Function of time. That is a variable. Okay.
Just a mass density.
Huh?
A mass density.
It's a spring mass damper system. Okay. So system variable would be x1 and x2. Right? State variable. It's a combination of x1 and x2. Okay? So you can come up with that state variable. State vector, again it's just a column. So the first thing we'll do is this is the differential equation, okay? You can either start here or you can start at the transfer function. So how do you start at the transfer function? We have m1 s square x of s plus c s. Since we have the camera now, this is just a two-mass spring mass damper system, okay? Two-mass translational system, translational mechanical system. So what we have done is we have applied Newton's law, okay? Newton's second law. We have arrived at the system equation. Okay? You can start here, which is a set of two differential equations, or you can start at the transfer function. You can start at the transfer function, correct? How do you start at the transfer function? How do you go about the transfer function? Remember? If you want to do the transfer function, just do some of the impedances. Just do that that technique. Some of the impedances apply to mass 1. Okay? Or motion x1 minus some of impedances common to motion x1 and x2 equal to sum of applied forces or applied inputs to x1. So you see that?
Can you define the
this one? So it's just, you can start here. See this one, if you take the inverse of this, it's this. Right? Or if you take the transfer function or Laplace transform of this, it's this. If you take the inverse of this, it's this. Or Laplace transform of this, it's this. And again, it's the same. You will need this. You cannot build your state space model with transfer function. You need the the differential form. You need the differential form. The purpose of state space modeling is I'll just take a minute to give you a perspective of what state space modeling does. Okay? You recognize this as a differential equation, right? This is calculus. Right? What you're going to see is I'm going to convert this calculus problem into an algebra. So the set of solutions available would be different. Okay? If you're trying to solve this for x1 and x2, you'll have to use purely calculus. If you convert this to algebra, you'll have a totally different set of solutions. And that is what we're trying to do here. Okay? So we start with the first step is define state variable. So, typically for this course, or the scope of this course, the number of state variables will pretty much be equal to the number of system variables. Okay? You can do that and get away with the course. But there might be, if you do start analyzing relatively more complex controllers, you may have to define the minimum number of state variables. In here, what we are going to do is, we're just going to define, especially for translational mechanical systems. This will change for electrical systems or electrical networks. So for translational mechanical systems, number of state variables is equal to number of system variables. So we assign Z1 as the first state variable. Z2 is a second state variable. So Z3 is equal to X1 bar, Z4 is equal to X2. We define these state variables, Z1, Z2, we'll do this. How many, what is the order of this system? Fourth order in that sense, but there are two second order systems. Okay. Coupled second order systems. So what you'll end up with, you'll end up with four first order systems, first order simultaneous equations. Okay. You take a fourth order system and express that as four first order simultaneous equations or algebraic equations. Now define state variable. We define state variable. What is state vector?
A state vector is a column in the state variable.
Right, so what would be the state vector here?
It is just the of the column.
Of what? Understand, these are system variables. The one on the on your right hand side are system variables. Your right hand side. The one on your left hand side are state variables. These are state variables. These are system variables. Okay. So you have state variables. Now first step is to form the state equation. Take a look at this. Okay. What have we defined now? If you take a look at the state space system over there, what have we defined? Right, but what have we defined? Give me that letter. What have we defined here? We have defined x, not x bar. This is x. Okay? Right. This is x. So what would be our x dot? What would be our x dot? All the dots of this variable. Okay. So Z1. That's it. Okay. So that is your X dot. So let's form the state equation. Okay. We'll express each one at a time. C1 dot is equal to what?
X double dot x, x double dot.
Which? X?
X double
one dot.
X double dot.
This is equal to? Read. Z2 dot is what? X1 double dot, right? And what is X1 double dot? If you look at here, you're with me?
Yeah.
X, one double dot. I have moved everything to the right hand side. Okay? So it is C over M, X1 double, X1 dot, plus K1 over M, X1 minus X2. Now, just replace the system variables with state variables. So this is C over M. What is X1 dot? What is this? X1? Z1, right? Minus? Z2. Okay? Similarly, Z3 dot is equal to, Z3 dot is equal to, is everything okay? I don't think everything is okay.
You don't think everything is okay?
Yeah, we missed out something. Victor? It's negative, right? Because we moved on the other side. See, we move this one on this side.
Oh, okay.
So this is negative, this is also negative.
Right.
Now all we are going to do is, we are going to capture this in the form of a matrix. Say it again.
For the state equation V2 dot.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so M2 dot, so
right,
the
right. Alright, so z1 dot is what? Z2, right? The first thing you do is, so take a look at this. You're trying to express it in this form, okay? You write down this, and you write down this. We have yet to write down this part. We have written this x. This, what is this x vector? It's just z1, z2, z3, z4. Okay? And similarly, z1 dot, z2 dot, z3 dot, z4. Okay? Now you want to complete the A matrix. So z1 dot is what? Z2, right? So if you, how do you multiply matrix? This into this. Right? So you need for z1, what you need is z2. So there is no z1 component, right? But there is a z2 component. So we need 1 here. That is how you multiply 0 into this, this into this, this into this, this into this. That is how you do matrix multiplication. Correct? So this is z2. Now let's do z2 dot. What is z2 dot? So minus k m1 over z into z1, right? Z, look at the z1, z2, z3 terms. We're trying to capture z1, z2, z3 terms. Okay. So z1, what is z1? Minus k over m1. Z2 is minus c over m2. Z3. Right. Well, just look at this. Okay. So that is how you do this. Okay. Now, I'll just move this. So, this will complete the U part. Okay. The BU part. You can either do this like this, or you just do, if you want really the B part. Okay. So why is this one? Where does f of t belong? F of t belongs with z4 dot. So you see, it has to come in this line. Okay? You have to look at wherever f of t belongs. If f of t was pointing here to m1, then it would have come in z2. And finally, the output equation. Finally, the output equations. We'll just do output equations and then we're done. Okay? So, I'm going to write the output equation here. Yes.
Where are we in the second?
Huh?
The plus.
Oh. Huh?
So, that. Where's that coming from?
U is the root. Now the output equation is Y. I will always give you what the output is. Okay? For example, here, if you are required to find a transfer function, you'll be given the output, right? I'll tell you, find
x2 of s over f of s. So what is the output
in this case? If I say find x2 of s over f of s, what is the output? X2, right? So x2 is output is a output variable is always a combination, linear combination of system variables. So the output equation would be
y is equal to
right. Even for output equations, what you do is you start, you write this first. Okay? So you write the state vector first. This is your state vector. In most cases, you will not encounter this term. The du term will not encounter, so don't worry about it. You mostly encounter y is equal to cx. So, if you look at y is equal to cx, what you need to first write down is x, the vector x, state vector x. And you look at what is the targeted output, right? So, the targeted output here is x2. All you need to do is 0, 1, 0, if you multiply these two, what are you going to get? If you multiply these two matrices, you get one term, right? It's z2. And z2 is? X2?
Yeah.
Actually, z2 is not x2.
Z2 is x.
So it's z3, right? Z3, sorry.
So it's 0. 0, 1, 0.
Okay? That is your output equation. So this is your state space representation. You have state equation and you have output equation. So you start with state vector, state variable. Again, just to go through, start with state variable, identify state variable. Form your state vector. Okay? Form the state equation one at a time. Once you have the state equation, all you need to do is arrange them in the form of matrix. You'll have your state equation in the form of matrix. And then the next step is output equation. Output equation, you'll be given what is the output being targeted. Look for the output being targeted. Write down your output equation. Read this first, this populate the state vector. And based on what the output equation which is being requested, what the output is being targeted, form your output matrix. Okay? Simple?